Καλησπέρα παιδιά και καλώς ήρθατε σε ένα νέο βίντεο. Αυτό είναι ένα βίντεο το οποίο δεν είναι κανονικό βίντεο, αλλά είναι κλιπάκι από stream. Αλλά έπρεπε να σας κάνω μια εισαγωγή, γιατί πρέπει να καταλάβετε τι παίζει, όσοι δεν ξέρετε. Όπως μπορεί να έχετε παρατηρήσει, έχω ανεβάσει ένα βίντεο Εμίλιος ο Άνεργος στο YouTube. Αυτό είναι πρόμο για ένα save ανεργίας που κάνω κάθε Παρασκευή στο Twitch. Ξεκινάω ο Άνεργος προπονητής και πάω να κατακτήσω τον κόσμο. Τι γίνεται, εκεί μας πήρε μια ομάδα από τη Β' Φιλανδίας, η MIPA, έτσι λέγεται αυτή η ομάδα. Ήταν στην τελευταία θέση, εμείς καταφέραμε και τη σώσαμε και τη σώσαμε με τα γκολ ενός παίχτη που μας κουβάλισε, του Νίκο Ικαβάλκο. Αυτός ο παίχτης είναι Φιλανδός ερασιτέχνης ποδοσφαιριστής, 31 ετών συγκεκριμένα. Ένα παιδί στο chat, σε εκείνο το stream, έστειλε το Instagram προφίλ του. Το είχε ανοιχτό, του στείλα μήνυμα, τον έκανα tag σε story, το έκανε share και χώθηκα 0011 και λέω πάμε, θα του στείλω μήνυμα. Και κατάφερε εν τέλει αυτόν τον παίχτη να τον φέρω σε συνέντευξη. Μπορείτε να απολαύσετε αυτή τη συνέντευξη. Για όσους δεν ξέρουν αγγλικά, θα έχει και υπότιτλους από κάτω. Γενικότερα, μην κλείσετε το βίντεο μετά τη συνέντευξη, μετά το τέλος συνέντευξης, γιατί πραγματικά υπάρχει ένα κομμάτι που έχει πάρα πολύ πλάκα μετά. Οπότε, σας αφήνω να απολαύσετε τη συνέντευξη. Νίκο Ικαβάλκο, striker στην MIPA. Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ τον Νίκο για τη συνέντευξη. Νίκο.
Yeah,
oh, you have a camera. You have a camera.
Of course.
Of course. Okay. So, please wait a little bit. Wait a little bit. Λοιπόν, έχουμε κάμερα, παιδιά. Man, the crowd is totally loving you, man. It's totally loving you. So, Nico.
Yeah.
First of all, it must be really strange for you to be in a Greek stream for totally no reason for you. Totally no reason.
Little bit. I was surprised when I saw that you put that. I didn't even know what was the game. I think, is it Football Manager?
Yeah.
I like the game.
Okay, so it must be pretty strange for you. I mean, you saw some follows on Friday from my fellow Greek viewers over there, and
yeah. On Saturday there came like 50 new 60 new followers.
Yeah.
Like, well, what is happening?
So let me explain you at first what exactly happened on Friday to give you some info about it. So there are lots of questions that I want to ask you, not only about your career, but also about your personality, about your hobbies, even your football knowledge, about Teemu Pukki. I saw many Instagram pictures about it, about him. So let's start from what are you doing exactly in your real life. Are you a professional footballer or not?
No, not anymore. I played as a professional the last 13 years.
Like. Yeah.
2 years ago, I started working in. I worked also as a bartender, and now I'm working in a school as a teacher's assistant.
Yeah.
And now next year I'm gonna start my coaching career also.
Oh, that's great.
I'm gonna start coaching juniors.
Yeah. So, are you playing for MIPA Milikos Kempalo or not at the moment?
Now I'm training with Kotepe.
Oh yeah, I saw that you've played a lot of years. In that club.
Yeah. That's my junior team where I started my football career.
Okay, that's great. Yeah.
Where I used to play before, so it's almost like a home for me.
I guess that you have like a winter break now at your championship.
Yeah. In here, the season starts in April.
Okay. Yeah. Which are the teams that you've played in the past? In the past years,
I played in Kotepe, of course, then MIPA, then FC Haka when it used to be in the Veikkausliiga. Okay, now they promoted back to Veikkausliiga, and then IFK Mariehamn.
So you have experience from the top tier of your country's football.
Yeah, I played there like 5-6 seasons.
Yeah, and which was your best season in terms of scoring?
I think second division season when I played in Kotepe 2013.
Yeah.
In the highest league, it was 2015 when I played in Kotepe also.
Yeah. Do you remember any of your teammates back then? Which was the best one you had in your footballing career?
Best one my football career. No, of course, Teemu is one.
Yeah.
But okay, he wasn't at that time when I played with him. He wasn't so good as he is right now. He was good, but not so. He was junior back then. Probably the best player I have played ever is, I would say, that kind of name, Beka Tukushi.
Okay, I will check this guy out. I don't know him, to be honest.
He's a Georgian footballer.
Oh, okay, nice.
Plays. Oh, I think he plays right now in Georgian league, top league. Has played couple games also in Georgian national team.
Was there any chance for you, in your past, in the past years, during the past, where you could play abroad? Did you have any chance to play outside of Finland?
I had already contract. Only thing what was needed was the signing of mine and the clubs. I was going to transfer to Udinese in 2008. Yeah, 2008. I break my ACL then.
Oh.
My first time, my first knee injury came. We were with national team. We were playing in Madeira. We were playing against Turkey, and I broke my knee first time. So the deal went off.
So becoming a player that played in one of the best championships in Italy was a dream that didn't become true for you.
Yeah, I had already my bags packed and I was ready to go, but then this suddenly came and never get back to that level I was.
Yeah.
The other time was Herven in Eredivisie.
Yeah.
They wanted to buy me, but they couldn't get agreement with Kotepe about the transfer fee. That deal fell
and,
down.
I think that Eredivisie selects many players from Finland during the...
Yeah. Many players want to go to Eredivisie because of Jari Litmanen and Sami Hyypiä.
Yeah.
Because they started their careers from there.
So what's your opinion about the Finnish football?
I think about Finnish football, for me, I would say... to a young player that he would have to go straight away to abroad when he can.
Yeah.
In Finland, the money is so small in Finland that you can live with it, but you can't really, you can do it like as a profession, but if you want to have some savings or something, because you know that it's going to end someday.
Yeah.
When you play top leagues there, you don't have to do after that anymore. You don't have to do nothing because you have money so much.
But I see that there is a lot of progress in the recent years for Finnish football. I mean, you achieved the qualification for Euros, for the Euros, and that's a big thing for you.
Yeah, that's true. But there's also the thing that if you watch the players who played the most of the minutes of the national team now, let's say 90% of them has left Finland before they turned 20 years old.
Yeah.
So they really haven't been playing in Finland so much. They have had their experiences more from abroad. So they are more ready to play the game.
So let's say that there was a team from abroad, for example, let's say a team from Serie B or from the second division of Netherlands, and they come and say to you, "You are our man. We want you to play for us." Would you do it? Do you think that you are in that level at the moment, or you are just finished from football?
No. Definitely, I would took that. That would be like the dream come true.
Yeah,
absolutely, definitely.
So, how old are you? 31.
I'm 31. Yeah.
I know because I play a lot of Football Manager, so yeah, it's like knowing your whole life better than you from this game. Yeah. Which is your favorite club, even from Finland and from abroad?
Real Madrid.
Real Madrid. Okay.
Yeah, from Finland, I think HJK.
Helsinki. That's a team.
Yeah.
From here. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Milkosken Pallo, the team that I manage in Football Manager, which is the city that they play in.
Myllykoski.
Oh, okay. Didn't know that. So and KDP?
It's close. KDP plays in Kotka. Kotka and Myllykoski, they have like 40 kilometers, 50 kilometers. They are, yeah, they are like next to each other.
Would you suggest to one of us to come to Finland? Are there plenty of things to see there, to visit?
Yeah, definitely, especially in the winter time.
Yeah.
Okay, of course, summertime also, but the winter time, because I think in Greece there is not so much snow around.
Yeah. Have you ever been in Greece?
I don't think so. I don't think so.
Yeah, you have definitely. You definitely have to come to visit the Greek islands. I mean, yeah, I saw from your Instagram profile that you like good life, so yeah, Greek islands are definitely a place to visit.
I believe that. I think they are a beautiful place.
Yeah, but you said earlier about coaching career. So what are your plans on it?
And now I'm going to start coaching 11-year-old boys. So, but my goal is to someday coach as a profession, to be as a head coach of some team in abroad, but I'm satisfied if I coach in Veikkausliiga also, the top level in Finland.
Do you have any coaching qualifications, any coaching diplomas?
I'm now starting to do those.
Okay, so at the same. Yeah, you are still young about it. I mean, you are still playing football, so yeah. About Football Manager, I have to ask you some questions about the game. Do you play Football Manager first of all?
Yeah, I haven't been playing now, like, last 2 years, but yeah, I played it before a lot.
Did you know that you even existed on that game?
Yeah. I've checked my own status in the Google.
And do you like your stats in the game?
They're okay.
They're okay, just okay. I mean, you carried us and we stayed in the league. I mean, you're more than okay for us.
Yeah. But I like him.
There was a Finnish legend in Football Manager, Mika Aritalo. Do you know him?
Yeah, I know.
Is he known? Is he popular in your country?
I wouldn't say popular, but if you are watching football, you know who he is.
Okay. So I checked also your Instagram profile, and I mean, you have some legendary pictures on your profile, to be honest. And I saw that you have lots of pictures with Teemu Pukki. Since when do you know him?
He's one of my best friends, actually. So when I was, I think, 17 and he was 15, I first started to train with the first team in Kotka, KTP. He's also from Kotka. We are from the same city. And then we became like really good friends because we played in the same team. We played as a junior level, same teams as a national team, junior national teams, under 21s, under 20s. Even he's like 2 years younger than me. I was in the teams. I was always like a little bit big brother to him.
Yeah.
Because we used to play always against the older guys in our team.
Have you ever believed that he could become a player like this? Like he is at the moment. I mean, he's carrying a whole team in the Premier League at the moment.
I always knew that he has the potential to be a player like that. But for me, the biggest problem about that he only like became that now, 29-year-old, is because his personality is a little bit shy and not so outgoing.
Yeah.
When he transferred to Brøndby and made goals in there and got his self-confidence up there, after that something changed a little bit also in his personality, in the pitch. Like he started to be more, let's say, bad.
Yeah.
I mean bad, like that way that he didn't apologize anymore from some, that if he misses or if tackles somebody.
Yeah.
He don't apologize anymore. And that's the biggest thing for him why he's right now at this level, I think.
Nice. So do you even compare yourself to Teemu? I mean, are you better on something, on football, on finishing, for example?
I'm better shooting penalties.
Oh.
And free kicks. I'm much better like if somebody plays the ball to my back against the goal.
Yeah.
or the ball comes to my head or my chest. He's better finishing inside the box.
Yeah. So you are a little step away from Premier League, man. I think.
I also.
Do you know any Greek football clubs?
Of course, I got in.
Yeah.
Then them was this close to get to Greece.
You are
no them.
Ah, Temu. Yeah. I mean, do you know any? Do you have any info about PAOK? Ωραία, τι μάθαμε εδώ πέρα, λαβράκι. So, for PAOK, I mean, how close was he to play for PAOK? So close. Nice, okay. So, do you know any other football clubs?
Of course, Panathinaikos.
And Panathinaikos had a Greek player in the past, Finnish player in the past, Robin Lod. Yeah.
I think he did good in Greece, yeah.
Yeah, he did really good. You do not remember any other club? I mean, you definitely have to remember one more.
What is this one? Atromitis or something like that.
You have excellent knowledge of Greek football, but there is one more. You have to say one more.
We had one Finnish Greece footballer in our national team also. Alexandros Souflakis or Souflakis, I think it was. I think it was Souflakis or something like that. I can't remember. Alexandros Souflakis. But it's like 10 years ago.
Okay. We also have in Greece souvlaki, which is Greek food, which is very tasty. I hope that you are not talking. You are not talking about this. No. It's okay. No. You know a lot about Greek football. Do you know any Greek player?
Samaras.
Okay.
He played with Temu in Celtic. I remember him.
Yeah.
A funny guy. then. Mitroglou, Papastopoulos.
Yeah, from Socrates. From you are the only man that wants to tell him by his surname. And...
No, it's easy to remember like this.
Yeah. Nice. It was a nice try. Yeah. Do you know Zeca? Zeca. Yeah, he's a Portuguese player that has gained the Greek nationality over the past few years.
No.
Okay, that's okay. You've also won the Euros back in 2004, so I guess that you may have heard some players from back then.
Karagounis,
Natos, ωραίος. Let me ask the chat of the stream if they have any question for you, but I can clearly see that they're all loving you, man. I mean...
That's good.
Do you know Perparim Hetemai?
Yeah,
he also played for AEK Athens.
Yeah, that's the bad thing, because when he went to AEK, they paid him like 500,000, and that was the money Kotepe wanted from me. That's why I couldn't go to the Hereven, because Hereven didn't want to buy 500,000, and Kotepe wanted 500,000 because Hetemai just moved to AEK for 500,000.
It's Perparim's fault that you didn't play higher in your career. Yeah. That's unlucky. Why Teemu Pukki hasn't moved to PAOK? What was the problem?
I don't remember. I think they ended up just that they thought that at the end that Norwich will be better than PAOK.
Yeah. If you had the chance, would you ever come in Greece to play football?
Yeah, definitely.
And only for first division teams or for lower two?
It doesn't matter which division.
Oh, nice! I like that you have you want to discover new things. I mean, it's great.
That would be amazing.
I would invite you to my team, but I play amateur football. I mean, it's in the Greek low league, so I think that you are too good for this level. Yeah,
maybe.
Yeah, who is your idol as a football player? I mean,
there's two, Ronaldo, the real one, the real Ronaldo.
The real Ronaldo is a phenomenon. El Fenomeno, okay.
Also Rau, those two.
Yeah. Can you compare your play style to another footballer's style? I mean, that you really seem like Vangelis Mantios, it's a Greek footballer, but...
As nowadays, if I would say about Greek footballer and compare myself to somebody as Greek footballer, I would say Samaras or Angelos Charisteas.
Yeah, also Charisteas is a very good choice, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you think that you had the chance to reach a higher potential in your footballing career? I mean, do you think that you could play in a higher level? You were a professional football player in Finland. I mean, that's also a great achievement. It's not easy to become a professional football player, but do you think that you could reach at a higher level in your career?
Yeah, in the past, I could think that I would have had the chance to reach the higher level, but I'm happy that what I made nowadays, and not anymore.
Yeah. Which are your plans about your life? What do you want to do in the future?
The coaching is one thing. Yeah. One thing which interests me. I don't like to make so big plans.
Yeah.
I like to go like day by day, and because you never know what happens.
Yeah.
Happens, but the coaching is the one thing what excites me and what I want to do.
Is there anything you want to say to our viewers? I mean, anything on your mind at the moment?
No, thanks for the interview, and hey guys, play Football Manager. You find legends in there.
Yeah, yeah. And believe me, I've tried to bring more players from Football Manager that became legends in our Football Manager series, and you were the first one that answered the call. I mean, that was really great. You are a really cool guy, and we like it a lot. And I hope that you keep carrying us on the game. And who knows, maybe you become our top striker in Veikkausliiga, and we will call you again to say congratulations for bringing us the title or something like that. Yeah,
that would be great. Yeah.
So thanks again for that.
Yes. And thank you.
We will be in touch for everything in the future. I mean, if you ever come to Greece, feel free to send me a message.
Definitely, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. So thank you, Nico. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Βλέπω τον Εμίλιο Καλοκαίρι Χαλκιδική να γίνει την κουνουπίδα που πατάει μαζί με η Καβάλκο και Πούκη. Κοίτα, να σου πω κάτι. Αν μου έλεγες ότι θα το κάνεις γι' αυτό, απίστευτο μου φαίνεται. Οπότε, κάτσε. Πρέπει να το δείξω. Πρέπει να το δείξω αυτό. Είναι πολύ καλό. Έτσι ήμουν εγώ καθ' όλη τη διάρκεια της συνέντευξης.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Varmasti me päältä tullaan nyt.